Hello and welcome back to another video. Today we're gonna make another mask tutorial. I feel like I'm long overdue since the last time. Last time's been around, I don't know, 1 year, almost 2 years in fact. Yeah, the last mask video was that long ago, and it seems that it's been doing well, the most well in the channel, so why not milk the cow some more? Well, in all honesty, these kinds of videos are really fun to make, but they are really time-consuming, and with all the studies, yeah, I can't really make them that often. Well, at least in the past. Now I guess I can make some since I am making this video. So, how about let's get right into it. Alright, first we'll be needing the most important part, the mask. And of course we'll be needing, well, paper for templates, and then the other stuff we'll be needing: scissors, cardboard, glue gun, super glue, pencil, of course various paints, but that depends on what color scheme you want. These are the most important parts for this project, so yeah, most likely any other material that I would be showing in the video would be optional, or it can be substituted with other materials. It can be just substituted with this. So yeah, let's get right into the tutorial then. First off, we'll be, well, drawing the shape of the mask. You can do this with any kind of mask. In fact, I have this specific shape, so I'll be doing this shape. You can do this with this kind of mask as well, the more, well, common ones. Just fold it in half like this. Like so, place it onto the thing, and well, trace it to the shape that you want. But I won't be using that, I will be using this since it's already pre-made. Watch the last video, the last mask video, if you want to know how I made these things. But I'll explain it in a quick way later on. So let's trace this mask. And there we have it. This is the shape of the mask, the half part of the mask that we will be making. So what you can do right here is, well, give it designs, anything that you'd like to put. I'll be making one myself, so I can make an example. You can alter the shape a bit if you want. I'll be making an example of that as well later on. So yeah, I'll be right back and make my own design. And that was quick. Here is the design that I have came up with. You see that these parts are the Velcro parts you saw in the mask right here. I've marked them as well, so I won't be confused. I have altered the mask a bit. You'll see the lighter shades, the lighter lines are the original shape of the mask. Right here, right there. The main template I'll be using is the darker shades of lines right here. This is just a design that I think I'll be making as decals later on. So yeah, you can alter the shape lightly if you want, but this is the half of the mask. So what's next is we'll be cutting the template itself and tracing it onto the cardboard. Alright then, the mask is all cut up, all segments. There is a particular way to, well, trace this onto the cardboard. So, well, let me just show you. Alright, so I've made the final template for the cardboard itself. There are some parts that are not exactly the right shape. there's a good explanation for that. It's because we need those extra parts there, so some parts can glue together. I can show you how that works later on in the video when we are going to glue them together, so you could understand more. Basically, what I did was give them parts that would overlap to each other so they can glue much better. Look at this. So this is the front plate right here, and this is the part where the nose guard is. So I've put a part here so it can just glue on right on there. See? It overlaps like that, and it could glue, and it would make the layering effect, well, layered. Same with this one. This is the part on the back, right on the cheek. I think this is part of the cheek. So it goes on like, wait, how does it go on? Yeah, right here, that's the original part. I've extended this part right here, extended that part right here. So this part could stick here, and this part could stick right there, and this part could stick right under there. At least that's a rough explanation for it. I'll make another copy right around here, now inversed, so they can, you know, stick together in the right way. And yeah, I think it would be more explained better once we glue it together. So let's get on cutting. Alright, everything's cut together and, well, made an inverse copy of it to make the full mask. Now, if you're wondering why there are lines, these are, well, the templates on where we would be gluing them. These are the additional details that I would be drilling on, and if you are wondering why these are here, I figured to, well, scratch this piece, since it's way too thin for my liking. This still be useful, this is usable still, if you want, I just wanted mine to have a bit more dimension to it. You'll see in the results what I mean, but what I'm trying to say here is I've made the lines to be the guide for where things should be glued and things should be placed, so I won't get confused. How I did it was by taking the original template, placing them right on where it should be, right here, and then tracing the line. Simple as that. I've also bent these things into shape, slightly curved, since, well, it's a mask, and it's going to fit right there perfectly. Bending these as well, like this, so it could stick in here without any hassle, and doing a slight cut, not all the way, as you can see here, just cut up the surface so it could fold better without, well, any mess. See this? I'll be trying to cover this gap here with something, but you can just leave it be or just use super glue to harden it so it won't, you know, break out. And that's pretty much it. Now, on to the next part. We'll be gluing specific things first. We'll be gluing the parts that would be the same color, namely these parts only. Since I'd be coloring these parts white and accents of red, these parts would be colored black and made to have a carbon fiber effect, and this would be silver. So yeah, these are the only ones that will be gluing now before painting, and these are all separate. I'll show you how things would be done in, well, a bit later on. So yeah. Alright, all the stuff that needs to be glued have been glued. Ignore the mess right there for now. So let's talk about the stuff that I've been doing. So I've treated. So what I've done is treated and detailed, also glued every part that can be glued before paint. This whole piece, the front piece of the mask, it's all glued. The side parts are a different color, so I'm not gonna glue them just yet. I'll be showing how I paint them later on. Also, these parts are gonna be silver in color. That's why they're also separate. I'll explain what these are later on. But first, what I did to this thing. So you can absolutely just glue them together without doing all of this. I've added details right here, the circle parts. I've added a detail here as well. And this one too. I did this by drilling holes, by using my, well, pin vise. Where is it? It's somewhere in here. My pin vise, or you could just absolutely just use a pen to poke holes into them and just twist them like so. Or a pencil, in fact, you can do those with those too. That's the reason why these are so clean is, well, after I've poked the hole, I've drizzled a lot of glue, super glue in them so they could harden. I continued to poke the hole like so in order to, well, widen them and make them more visible. After that, I sanded the surface. See, that's why it's smooth and flat right here. I've sanded the surface so, you know, to make it all clean together. I've also glued the sides, drizzled super glue right here, repeatedly, and sanded them a bit so they won't, you know, unravel, since that's the problem with this kind of cardboard. It does unravel if there's too much stress on the edges. And to explain these parts, these are putty. You can just leave this out, but if you do, you'd have the seams visible right here, and I didn't want that, so I used putty, sanded them down. I glued every single part of this because it needed to be sanded, super glued. In fact, it just got soaked and it hardened. See? And yeah, now it's pretty much all cleaned up. The seams are sealed. You don't need to do all these extra stuff. You can just glue them together like this. Even these, you can just glue them together if you wanted it in just one color. I just did this because it's on my preference. So hopefully I explained that well enough. Next up, I'll be painting these and I'll be explaining how I painted them. Also, I forgot, you don't need to do this, but just for more security, I did put foam on the back side here, on the seams, right here too, where it all connects on this edge, because it does stress a lot and it might break apart if you're not careful. So just putting that additional security on the back would be really, really helpful for it being more long-term. Alright. Onto the painting. Okay, so I'm pretty much guessing most of the parts are all painted up. I messed up on some parts of the masking. I forgot to mask a part here, so I know where to glue. I'm not gonna glue this part here anymore. I'm just gonna glue the entire thing right here. So that's a change of plans, and I messed up a lot of masking here because I thought I could get away because there's this piece right here, but no, I just messed it up. So yeah, learn from your mistakes, just mask the lines properly, you'll be good. But I think I still know where to glue them. Right now, there are a lot of detail paints that I still need to do, but I can do that after I can glue them. I can do them before, but I think I want to see how it looks before giving the detail paint. I'll be painting these parts red. Red right here, a red line under here, or, well, right on the edge. I'm not sure if I'll be giving a bit of detail right here. We'll see. I'll be making markings as well, similar to, well, it's missing, here. I'll be giving markings as well, similar to what I've sketched out here. A big old number one right here, because this is the first original mask design that I did, or just design elements from Metal Gear or Cyberpunk, which you prefer. I still think I got most of the design elements from Metal Gear, so yeah. I'll try giving my best shot at making a barcode somewhere here, because I kind of like that aesthetic. So yeah, how about let's glue all of it together first. Alright, this whole section is still messy. Don't mind that, these foam parts are gonna be needed for later. I've run out of, well, glue sticks, so I can't really put these onto the back right here for the Velcro and supports. Putting this part here for support on where it's connected. It's already ripping off, but that's fine. Here as well. And then put these parts right here for support onto the Velcro so it won't get ripped off as well. But I don't have hot glue sticks, so I'm not able to continue on that part. So let's go ahead and paint the red accents instead. So at least there would still be more progress until I could buy more of those stuff. Oh, actually let me talk about this. I've glued everything together, assembled, well, pretty much the right way, I think. Well, I think it's cool enough. It's okay enough. It's pretty cool. I like how it looks so far, and I've added the black lines. I forgot to record that. I'm sorry, but I just traced it with, I don't know, water-based acrylic, and just smudged away the excess here as well. We'll be painting this centerpiece red, so that's fine. These two, the bolt things here, and then a line right here. I'm not sure if I'll be painting the bottom part red as well, but I'll be painting the inside of this part red. So yeah, oh, I've also glued this thing right here to give it a layered look onto the armor to give it more, well, layers and depth onto the look. I found that the cloth mask itself just didn't look quite natural, so I added a piece of foam, folded it in half, and glued it onto the back and shaped it to where the nose would be. Turns out it protrudes way too far, but that's fine. It still looks cool. I just needed an extra layer to get the nose flush onto the mask itself, and it makes the layer look more, you know, armored and actually professional, and not just paper, cardboard, and stuff. Alright, I've talked about that enough. Let's go on to the painting. Slight problem, my memory got full and I couldn't finish the time lapse. I didn't notice that it got full, so I just continued. But basically everything here, right here, these are decals that I have from my model kits. Here, 01. These are all just decals, and all of the time-lapse that's important has been recorded, which is the painting of this, 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 and this part. Also, I changed back the thing because it looked like a face too much. Yeah, okay, let's continue. All that's left is these parts right here, gluing them into the back. Reinforcements right here on the edge, right here. And the reinforcements for the Velcro right here. Alright, so everything's there, everything's fixed. Reinforcements there, reinforcements here, the Velcro's already glued in there. It is now perfectly usable, but I wanna add something extra, namely weathering. You can absolutely use black or dark gray. You can't use silver since it's white and it will be barely visible. So yeah, I'll be using dark. Gunmetal, since it's still a metallic color and it's darker than silver, so yeah, let's go ahead and do the weathering. Everything's done, finished, painted, weathered. I kind of got overboard right here, so I just painted the weathered parts here white, so it's not that messy looking. I've gone through again right here to fill in those not so filled parts, also here as well, to make it, well, look better. It's all weathered up, it's all detailed up, everything's finished, and this was a very fun project to actually do. I forgot how fun making these kinds of videos are. It just really took time this time, but, well, at least it's not repetitive. It's a really fun project, and I'm planning on making some more of these kinds of videos in the future. I may or may not make the next video as another mask project, since someone suggested that I should make a Sundowner inspired mask for the next one, but we'll have to see, since, well, Sundowner's mask is kinda unwieldy and I need to redesign it to be usable in public, although it does still look badass. This is also really cool. I'm surprised I made the barcode look, well, actually like a barcode, and the font here look actually like a number. All of these are all from leftover kits, leftover water slide decals, water slide decals. Oh my god, I can't say anything. And yeah, also, if I haven't mentioned already, I used Velcro. I forgot if I mentioned it or not, so yeah, I used Velcro on that one as well. You'll be needing Velcro. So yeah, this has been a fun project, a really, really fun project, and I'll definitely make more in the near future, but for now, just enjoy how it looks, and see you guys next time.